The Islamic State has flaunted their targeting of all non-Muslims, from their videotaped beheadings to their bombings of religious sites. They don't even have mercy on women and children. Now, some of the girls and young women have escaped their brutal forced marriages.
I have been sold in Syria. I stayed about 5 days with my two sisters. Then one of my sisters was taken to Mosul, and I remained in Syria.
This 15-year-old Iraqi girl was trafficked by ISIS into Syria, but escaped back into Iraq.
He told me, "I'm going to change your name to Abir, so your mother doesn't recognize you. You'll become Muslim, and then I will marry you." But I refused to become a Muslim, and that's why I fled.
Amsha Ali is 19 and married, with one son and another on the way. She and her boy were taken in August and held for more than 3 weeks before escaping.
I saw a lot of murders of Yazidis, but the killing was not the hardest part for me. Even when they forced my husband, brother-in-law, and my father-in-law on the ground to be murdered, it was painful, but marrying into ISIS was the worst. It was the hardest thing for me.
The ISIS terrorists consider Yazidis to be heretics, and they force the young women to convert, to flee their homes, or to die. Amsha somehow found her way back to what is left of her family, a fate better than hundreds, even thousands, of other ethnic and religious minorities forced to become Muslim child brides. John Waghi, CBN News.